shellfish grower from Washington State, so in the northwest corner of the United States. I work for a company that grows clams, oysters, mussels. So I was invited to come speak at this forum, at the scientific forum, about the effects of ocean acidification on my industry and on my company. It's preventing our ability, or impacting our ability, to grow baby oysters. So as the ocean absorbs carbon dioxide from anthropogenic inputs, it changes the acidity of the ocean, and it changes the availability of carbonate ions, which makes it more difficult for oysters to build their shells. And so in the first couple days of life, that's a really critical stage for oysters. 90% of the weight that they're putting on is shell. And if there isn't enough carbonate ions, they have to work really hard to do that. And they're doing it with energy from within their egg, and they run out of energy before they get to develop their feeding mechanism, so they die. So we're having really high mortalities with waters that are upwelling off the coast of Washington State. They're very low pH, high CO2 levels in that water, and it's affecting our ability to produce our baby oysters because of that. There's a lot of other organisms in the ocean besides oysters that are calcifiers that don't have a spokesman like me out there advocating for them. There are things that you and I don't eat, but things that you and I like to eat rely on for their food, and they're being impacted as well. So it's important that people understand that this is not just an oyster problem. This is a big problem that's really getting at the base of the entire food chain in the world's oceans. So it's something that policymakers need to wake up to and realize that this is an issue that, whether you believe in climate change or global warming or not, this is an entirely separate problem caused by CO2 emissions that, in my opinion, is far more serious. My outlook at this point is encouraging, again, just because more and more people are listening that need to be listening. I've worked as a shellfish farmer for 30 years. And I know the ocean is resilient. In my own career, I've seen major pollution issues that were impacting the ocean fixed, and I've watched the ocean heal. And so I know, that if we stop impacting it, it will come back. The sooner we stop, the quicker it will come back. And with this CO2 issue, what we've learned from the scientists is this is a big deal, and it's really important that we start to turn the ship sooner than later, or it will take hundreds of thousands of years to reverse course.